And of course, in the Indian markets as well, the jewellery companies for the last couple of days haven't been very comfortable. Let's also hear out this S. Subramaniam, the CFO of Titan. He spoke to us earlier in an interview and said that the impact of GST bill on jewellery company would be likely in a range of 2 to 6%, which is almost in line with 2% tax that is applicable currently.
One thing we have definitely seen over the last 3-4 months after the excise duty has come in, the impact that we are seeing on the jewelry business, and I think this is something we've been hearing across the board, 30 to 40% drop in jewelry sales over this period, is, I think, largely, I mean, our hypothesis is largely to do with the crackdown on black money. So we are going to see a period of correction, maybe a year or two, where there would be muted sales, but that's because the industry is correcting itself. And of course, customers are also wary of investing in gold when more and more disclosures are required from the government side. We have an excise duty of 1%, general VAT of about 1% across the country. So 2% is where we actually are. The bigger problem that we were worried earlier was that if the rates were supposed to be in the region of around 6%, tax evasion could be high, and that would impact organized players like us. Having said that, with the excise duty 1% coming in, it's not about the 1% as much as the need to have documents across the board, which will be tracked. And therefore, it's only likely that more and more, almost all jewelers would have to have proper documentation, and which means that there would be a fairly level playing field as far as the organized player is concerned as well.
Well, absolutely. One, the international prices in, for gold have gained up by 25%. More documentation.